follow up with that, I'm surprised. But maybe just waiting to see whether the Sting goes out of the game fairly early.
I reckon it might.
In the second semi-final, Karras got it down. It was shot by Bell. He's turned it over. Opportunity for Medcraft. Gets on the left boot. Goes down the corridor. Caught behind with Suni. Got hands to it. Couldn't complete the mark. It was Lamb for the Western Lions. Got it on to Riley. Goes in the direction of McKenzie. Can't keep the ball in the field of play. Just forward of centre wing on the outer or southern side of the ground. Advantage side for Sunbury. To the eastern goals.
Jack Sheehan has started defensively for Sunbury. He's standing Lee Ryle at centre half back.
It's Karras who got it down, shaped nicely by Colbert. Had a little bit of space to move, goes up the half forward, and Ryle presenting. Bounced off the chest, he'll need to recover. He's got a little bit of support there. Handball backing board goes to Barker. Ball at ground level, Karras putting his body on the line. Was he taken high? Was he taken front on? Play on to the call by the umpire. He'll come in and he'll elect to ball it up, literally just forward of centre attacking side for Dan.
Jeff Bell started on the ball. Pat Britt standing, Simon Clark in the Sunbury forward line.
We're back in the contest now. It looks as though it's an over-the-shoulder decision going the way of Karras, is it, or is it going the way of Dickinson? I think both players are looking. It is, yeah. Now, I just went in the wrong direction, but it will be the Redan Premiership Ruckman.
Watch Ryan White. He started defensively for Redan, but he's going to look to run off at every stage. He seems to have Josh Burgess down there, and you've got the feeling that he'll kind of play the quarterback role again today for the Eastern Lions.
Lovely pick up right on the boundary line by Medcraft. Tap back was clever by Sheehan. Won't dispute again. Just toe-poke forward by Riordan to Barker. Put it on the piece. He's taken in a terrific tackle. Freed the arm. Still got the handball out. And in the end, running out of space was Barker by the looks of it. And he'll just step it over the boundary line in front of the East Point Social Club.
Love watching Ash Barker play. He's like a spark plug with legs.
Absolutely. And after the game, a kick with legs.
Yes.
So it was Ryle from behind. Spilling onto it nicely was Coleman. Dangerous handball to the teeth of goal. McKay there couldn't pick up the loose ball and he's put it over the scoreline for the first score of the afternoon. He goes the way of Redan.
I'm surprised with the start of the game. Sunbury worked well very quickly, but Redan able to cut off through the middle of the ground.
Yep. And it's Matthews over the top to Phelps. Phelps can set sail from about 40 out. It's Horbury right on the line. Couldn't hold on to the mark, and it actually pushed to the right the Phelps kick. Now, I'm not sure that he's 100% fit at the moment, Damien Horbury.
So Sunbury going, it looks to be with the zone, but the kicking is not working all that well, though. Redan bringing it forward once again.
McKay, across half-back, brings the ball across his body. It's a two-on-one, and Hollington flying high, couldn't complete the mark, ball at ground level. Colbert did well, but then turned the handball over to Short. It's got slight on there, and then Linton goes in the outer portion of the booty. He'll run it along the boundary line. Oh, a bit of excitement from Xavier Linton there. Couldn't complete the deal. And Sunbury have brought the ball up to 60 around from their goal.
If Sunbury had gotten away, then they had a very open forward line as well. The Redan numbers are kind of flowing with the ball at the moment. You can see they've got the numbers back there now, but Sunbury were away then.
Boundary throw. In the end, it fell short of his belt. Tapped it in his face. Shoots it there, right up against the boundary line. Control football takes it over. And on true, the centre wing on the Northern Bowls Club side of the ground. Bring the ball back into play.
Interesting matchup in the middle of the ground. Brendan Peace standing next to Ryan Monzel.
Rather, it was Karras worked out of it by Dickinson. Barker couldn't control the loose ball. Bounce off his chest. Opportunity for Peace. Taken in a good tackle. No prior opportunity. Smack back in the middle of Eastern Ovals. And the former Redan Premiership coach brought back to the umpire. Puts the ball skywards again. Karras tapped it back, but not to his size advantage. Barker got it on to Matthews. Put the handball over the top of the bell. A little space to run. He'll cut the ball low. Goes looking for a teammate inside 50. Front and square was Phelps. He'll swing the ball back goalwards. He arcs it back towards the central upright, but unfortunately misses narrowly.
Probably should have had a clearer shot. His two teammates got into his space then. Phelps was on the lead. He had a clear run at the ball. Teammates cut it off. He had to do the groundwork then.
So Redan, three behinds. Sunbury yet to score, and they'll run it out of defensive 50. Will Sunbury through Coleman? So Burgess is going to be pushed fairly and squarely in the bank against Ryan Wade.
Got it.
And that's the way the umpires stand. So Burgess, defensive side of centre wing, kick long down the line, looking for Snipe. Got behind, complete the mark with hand numbers there through Colbert. He was dispossessed. Amble over the top by Matthews. On to Riley, back on to Lamb. And Lamb will kick to centre half, or to centre wing rather. And a terrific mark taken in front by Burgess once again. But Burgess will swing around on the left boot. He'll go up to centre half forward. Clark working his way forward. Got hands to complete the mark. Hyden, quick hands to Bell. And Bell can spot up Dickinson in the middle of the ground. Hands off to the runner, Schultz, and Schultz will go up to half forward to Riordan. Ball set up nicely for him, solid before he got it. And the ball tracks away from Adam Short that time and over the boundary line.
The reason the ball was at this end of the ground is solely because of Pat Britt. The way he was able to work Simon Clark under the ball and got him out of position then, so that it then became a 50-50 contest.
Well run. Hyden will look to square up to centre half forward where he's got a player on. Dundon takes the mark, got the runner McKenzie, thought about sending it goalwards, goes up inside 50, and Colbert takes the mark on the second effort. And Daniel Colbert, the former Mount Clear Junior, can line it up.
Important kick for Redan. They've had the only three scoring shots of the game so far. They need this to go through the two uprights, otherwise they are wasting the golden start of this game.
The ball spent the majority of this, I think, 6.5 minutes in their half. Colbert, we kick him from 35 metres out. Sends it goalwards and he's split the middle there. So first play goes the way of Redan. They move along to 1-3-9. Sunbury yet to score, just ticking into 7 minutes into this opening term on BFL Game of the Round. It's the second semi-final. The winner, of course, to progress through to the grand final. The loser this afternoon through to the preliminary final. Sean Kelly.
It's only very early days, but the way Redan are moving the ball and overlapping with their run as well, really good as well. They brought Dean Chester onto the ground at the moment. He's going to start on the wing, so it just gives him another bit of bite.
Got the savage in the ruck, but it was won by Redan. Getting the clearance up to centre half forward. Riordan attacked the football. Went back, retrieved it. Got player out wide and Bell. Through traffic, got it onto Karras, but Karras's kick was chopped off by wrist, didn't go the required 15. We'll hand off to the teeth of goals, where Chambers swing it wide. And right half back. Short takes the mark. Sunbury can bring it into the middle of the ground. Very kick though. It was chopped off by Chester. Cuts the ball low. Standing waiting for it was Horbury. Got himself out of trouble. And he probably didn't deserve to that time, Damien Horbury, and then just ruined it all by trying to go with the banana kick on the left. He's kicked it straighter than he has for some time.
Everything went well until he tried to put it on the outside of his left boot rather than swinging around onto the right, which shows me that Damien Horbury very one-sided.
Yes, he's always been a left-sided player. Still deep inside defensive 50. Look to switch play. Goes across the defensive goal square. Tucking it down low is Short. Thought about playing on quickly. In the end, he's going to return in kind. He's looking for McCabe. Stood his ground. It was won nicely by Peace. Kept the ball in the field of play. Got it on to Phelps. Taken down in a terrific tackle. Ran out of space in the end. Dead Chambers that time. And it'll be a boundary throw in. About 20 around that from the Redan goal. Long looping throw in. Machine in front. It was won by Dundon. Threw the ball on the boot. And despite the diving effort from Chambers, footed his fingers. And he's rolled it through for a goal. So Redan get the second. And they've skipped out by 15 points. 2-3-15. Sunbury yet to score on the BFL Game of the Round scoreboard.
Sloppy checking by Sunbury at the stoppage then. Inside forward 50 and leaving Jesse Dundon kind of unmarked. He was able to get the ball. Really good ruck play by Dickinson. He realised that Dundon was out on his own. Got the tap down. Dundon able to thread the needle. Redan's second goal of the day. They're looking the better side so far.
16 goals for the season. Jesse Dundon in second in this final series. Kovacevic acted down, but it was won by Matthews for Redan. He can get around on the left boot. You've got up to half forward. The contest provided by Short. Got Riordan out of it. Got the handball on out of it. Got the runner held. On to Kovacevic. He'll swing the handball wider still where it's got Cheap. Cheap will keep it low in the direction of Slide. Sliding down low. Snipes taking the mark.
It's the best pass kick play by somebody all day so far.
That was a terrific setup across half back.
They did, they were able to flip it around until they got that right person to deliver forward. Ross Slide gave the early long lead and was able to take it down.
So Slide, 45-degree angle, will be kicking from 49. Right foot drop, Party's pushed it to the right. He's pushed it so far, he's put it out of bounds on the full, so something still yet to get on the scoreboard. As Riley, was that weight?
Waiting.
It is waiting, yeah. Good to bring it back in.
Coming out this side, Wadey, that's better.
He does come out to the northern side. Clark got hands to it. This one by Colbert, taken down in a good tackle. Well won by McKenzie. He's got himself out of traffic. Brett, now onto Riley. Shrug one tackle. Still needs to get ahead of and one by McKenzie again. Floating ball goes up to half forward. Working his way forward was Barker. Left it for Dundon on to Ryle, now back to Barker. Looked to come back inboard. You go to the top of the square in the direction of Horbury. Couldn't take the mark, it was fisted away. Ball at ground level. Dundon tried to feed the quick little handball out. Karras is there, he's taken down in the tackle. Rolls back onto the football. The umpire's coming in now. He's going to elect to ball it up. 20 out on the side angle from the Redan goal. 11 minutes in.
Perfect reason why we've talked about Hayden Rowe and Cameron McKenzie pre-match. Their run off half-back that time and their fearlessness is why the ball's in the Redan forward line.
Sheen got it down. It was run by Short. This little kick, inadvertent as it may have been, has been taken on the chest by McCabe. Sloops a little pass over the top. Long-sleeved Hill. Square it up. Yeah, Coleman. Ray Smart stops and props and then he'll just go lateral. Back in board by hand to Hill. Hill just a little pass over the top. Trapped nicely by Scott Locke. Loop the handball off to the run of Hill. And Hill just pulled a little pass right onto the chest of Xavier Linton. Now, quite sure that went the required distance.
It went 15.1.
14.9, but there you go.
Glass half full, glass half empty.
Indeed. So Xavier Linton, summary yet to score after 12 minutes of this first term. Linton coming back from suspension. Skips to 48 now. Right foot drop, Party's kicked through that one nicely, but he's pushed it to the left. So on the scoreboard.
And looking such a different side when they're able to set up the ball across half back and have the time to make a decision as well. When they're doing that, they're doing it well. So that's what they need to start doing again. Just really getting clear space and not trying to rush too much into it.
So Riley, go to the southern side of the ground. He's put it out of bounds on the full. Don't play it by the side, touching that before it head over the boundary line. So Scott Love from 60 out. Right up against the boundary line, he'll look to put it to the hot spot. Gov Sevens from behind, lurking dangerously. With Jade Cheek at its off hands and through for a minor score. Something just appeared to have settled in the last 5 minutes or so, so they need a little bit more of the football. And again, kick out from the full back to the northern side stand. The boundary line, the fans being touched. Cheek. Chip short, looking for Clarkson to get pushed in the back. This one nicely by Medcraft, and a terrific goal from the left forward pocket. Angle was tight, but the expert, the finish was expert, and Matthew Medcraft gets Sunbury on the scoreboard with their first goal. They move along to 1-2-8. Redan 2-3, 15, the margin 7 points in the opening terms of 13 and a half minutes into this second semi-final.
Costly error by Redan because it was solely their mistakes. If you were to take the stats, you'd put that down as a shot. Because twice in a row, they managed to kick the ball in from full back and it rolled out of bounds without anybody touching it. It's one of the cardinal sins in football. It turns the ball straight over to an opposition. And when you're doing that, you automatically back that ball that they're going to make you pay.
So Ed Knapp with his 40th goal of the season was run by Phelps through the middle for Redan. He put it into the corridor looking for Horbury, couldn't complete the mark. Ball at ground level, Shane needed to get it out, did so to Short. Just threw the ball on the boot and Linton sets himself and takes a terrific mark with a good lead. Left half back, Bowls Club side, cut it low with his ball. Okay, defensive point of the square. Okay. And a 50-metre penalty. Well, it couldn't have been Dickinson on the mark or on the floor because he just didn't press forward. In fact, it's going back to Linton. So Linton will keep it low in the direction of Clark. It was dropped by Waite under pressure. Redan right. Teeth of Brown on the last line of defence. He can see the minor to score, but just a few breaks here for Redan in the last 5 minutes or so.
Somebody was saying, yeah.
Yep. Bring it in quickly. It was tapped forward by Sierney. We're going into the path of Meadcraft. He'll size it up from about 40 out. And he's just gone across the face. Again, another defensive mistake by Redan. They don't pay this time.
Manny Meadcraft's so dangerous in that ball.
There too.
I was about to write it down.
It's in the direction of Colbert.
What they're doing from fullback shows that Redan defensively are spooked by the presence of this tall spine of Sunbury, because they're going very wide with their kickouts. Obviously, their preferred option is going down the spine, but they can't do it because it's Sunbury tall.
Quick hands by Slide in the direction of Scotty Long. Tackling possession, he was wrapped up immediately. And a right half forward, 5 metres or so in from the boundary line. Maybe there's memories of that return of the last year's grand final too. It's Morton Redan at the minute. Looking handball over the top, looking for Sienic. Well, attacked by Lamb. Take clean possession of the football. Seemed to be a high tackle on the Mulleton. Dean Matthews square it up. Still inside, deep inside the fence at 50, but it's way
this
taken.
Get there,
and
get there!
Colbert. Just a little too wide. The execution not great at the moment by Redan. And the back of Matthew Colbert that time.
Redan Skiller has pulled something back into this game in the last 6 or 7 minutes.
This one, whether Sunbury pressures increased as well.
I think that might be the case.
Colbert won it comprehensively in the ruck. Shark nicely by Jeep. Football won by Hart. The freak has been kicked out. It's going to go the way of Hayden Riley.
Give me something!
The defensive 50 at my half back.
Go!
While up against Schultz got a good bounce, but then with the look away handball, missed the target. Meadcraft couldn't quite pick up the football. Riley's in there. On the Colbert, one more. Back to Schultz. Through Matthews. Matthews will go up to half forward, working his way forward. Was Dunham, couldn't complete the mark. Ryle was taken out of the contest. Parker's in there. He couldn't take clean possession of Pat Forms. Right half forward.
Dean Chester was running down the outer wing there. They could have given that one more. Rather than kicking to a 50. Chester had plenty of space to run into.
Machine who got high, Meadcraft just toe-poked it forward, dropped off by Chester. It's the ball to sit nicely for him. Eventually he was able to retrieve it, then take it down in the tackle dispossessed. Karras, quick hand on left boot. He'll just arc the ball across his body. On top of the square, the ball sat up. It was won nicely by Hill initially, but then Hayden Riley put his body on the line. Won by Hill, gets himself free, and he'll hook the ball guardwards and makes no mistake. Well, reward for pressure that time to Tim Hill. And Sunbury, unbelievably, are in front for the first time this afternoon. They lead by a point, 2-4-16, Redan 2-3-15 on the BFL game of the round scoreboard. But look, their frontal pressure that time, Sunbury, was excellent.
We both lauded Hayden Olive for the way he went in with it, went back, kind of back with the football. He couldn't hold onto it, and that's a skill of the ball then. That was where Sunbury swooped in. We knew as soon as they got the ball inside there with how it was open, Sunbury were going to have the advantage.
Harris on this round nicely, got it down to Meadcraft, who gets the clearance up to centre forward.
Oh, easy, easy.
And then Clark in front takes the mark down low. Wasn't a great kick off the boot by Matthew Meadcraft, but the advantage of playing in front.
And the tap that he got from the feet from Paddy Karras, it made it happen. And just shivering his jump in his seat when he realised he'd left him out of his top 20.
So Clark with a horrible kick from 55 out. It's going to fall short at the top of the square, coming across from the side with the spoil. It was Lamb. Can he keep the ball on the field? He can't. And then the right forward pocket. Poor effort by Simon Clark.
Exactly. That's all that hard work undone when Clarkie kicked an absolute sack.
So 20 around from the Sunbury goal kick to the Peel Street end. Thrown back in. Karras back into the path of Bell that time. On to land back to Bell by a hand. Had his kick smothered at ground level. One by Karras, using his strength, got the ball on the left boot. And the man in front, taking the mark on the chest, is Ross Slide. And pretty much directly in front, just 15 metres out, having taken the mark, Ross Slide should give Sunbury a 7-point advantage as we've ticked in the time on.
Matthew Medcraft has made the step from being a really dangerous forward player to almost an elite midfielder. He's shown it over the last month, and today he has been instrumental in this comeback.
So Slide will kick from 20 metres out, kicks through that nicely, and he splits the middle.
It shows how dangerous that Sunbury are with these forward targets that they have. As you saw, it was a quick kick out of the back, and Slide was in the perfect position to take the mark. He had front spot and he had the strength to hold off his defender so that he was able to mark on his chest and pivoted himself so that he was marking the backside of the ball as well. So
smart football, very smart football. But we saw it with Clark a little bit earlier, yeah. Even though it was uncontested, it was that short ball that came in. He was in front, Britt was caught behind, there was too much distance between the two at the fall of the ball. And even though Clark's effort was pretty ordinary with his kick.
Since those two kicks that went out on the full from the full back without being touched, this has turned into a completely different ball game.
So ball back in the middle again, Colbert up against Karras, and again Karras held his ground, got it down, but it was won by Colbert. Goes up the centre half forward, Riordan squirked his way under the football a little bit too much. James did well. He's got the run of McGovern. And McGovern will go out to centre wing on the outer side of the ground in front. Was trapped nicely by Hay. Got it back this time to, quite see who that was. He brought it up to half forward, but it's going to be Redan across half back, and it's Riley who squares it up where he's got Hayden, and now they can switch play because Schultz leaves it for what he otherwise would have taken. That support from Gergovic. A hand on to Schultz again with a little way handball. Wasn't a great one, but he had support there in the bell. Gergovic goes back to the run of Schultz, and Schultz floats a ball up to half forward. Didn't really favour Ryle. Well done by McKenzie, but then he was dispossessed. Tracking onto it nicely was Ryle, but then he was held up by Sheen immediately. And right on the attacking 50-metre page.
Redan's foot skills coming off half back have been shaky in the last couple of minutes. They kick some floaters going forward, and it's hurt their forwards.
Sheen turned the handball over. It was won by McKenzie, who just puts a high up and under ball. Sunbury getting numbers back. It was won by Phelps. Tried to get himself out of traffic. Taken in a terrific tackle. Should be and is rewarded to Sunbury. And we'll go the way of Styles. And Styles will go laterally where he's got McCabe. Takes a bounce on defensive 50. He'll approach the northern wing. Just looks a little past the link. Continues to run. Definitely handled over the top to McCabe. His handball was a great one. It was quite nicely by Chief. Dancing around the couple. Brings the ball back in ball, but it should favour Bell. It takes the mark in front of Burgess, and they just continue to run. Puts the ball up high to centre half forward. Riordan flew high, couldn't complete the mark. Ball at ground level again. Spills to McGovern, and he can mop up across half back, and he'll kick out to centre wing looking for Burgess. Burgess sold it before he had it. While I think the boundary line was just emerging there in his eyesight. Took his eye off the ball just momentarily and allowed the ball to go over 23. And a quarter minute in. So just forward, centre wing, advantage for Sunbury. It was Burgess cleverly tapped it back to Styles, who was dispossessed at ground level. It was won nicely by Dundon. Handball by Redan that time in the direction of Bell. Might hit the target on the foot. And the boundary line's the winner on this occasion. We'll throw it back in. Exactly where we were some 20 seconds earlier. Just about inside of centre wing for Sunbury.
Whoever gets possession of this, if they can get clear possession, they're away. Both forward lines extremely open.
Back in the way from Burgess, that's good ball. Matthews get the bounce he was looking for. Risk was taken high, still at ground level. It was won by Barker for Redan. You bring the ball inside 50, but the man in front, he read it much better. Attacked the football, took the mark on the chest. His Chambers, Neil. Switch play where he's got McKay. Still inside defensive 50. He's got Linton on short if he wants it. Forced to the first effort, but he did find Clark. Back to Risk this time. Risk to pass over the top to Colin. He's away. Get on the left boot. Partly smothered. He put it into the path of Burgess, but again, the boundary line a little too close. And Coleman just a little lazy in his execution that time. His non-preferred left, admittedly, but probably should have done a little bit better.
Yeah, 100% right. Somebody just starting to tighten up. Redan starting to tighten up defensively.
Another series. Ground level was won by White. Threw the ball on the left boot and able to trap it on the half volley. Ryle then applies a sloppy tackle.
Sloppy tackle, but the endeavour was right there, and it's something we haven't seen from him all day. He attacked that football up on the lead out of centre half forward, so I can't fault him for that.
And Tim Hill kick it into the corridor. It's to a packed situation. Now the whistle's gone. Now it's going to be a free kick to Pat Carris. Advantage paid. Running into the open goal is Greg Hayne. They've got another one.
So maybe we can't. I don't reckon we can fault Ryle for his attack on the ball. The execution of the tackle, though, as you mentioned, sloppy, and in the end it's forced to turn over. There was a free kick, Greg got in the back of Pat Harris. That's where the free kick was. It over the fall down to Greg Hay, taking the advantage and run into the goal.
And generally what they're doing is they're kicking long inside attacking 50, which is putting the Redan defenders under pressure. And there are a lot of similarities to the opening quarter of the grand final. Maybe not in terms of the margin at the moment, but there are some worrying signs there for Redan. And Sunbury 4-4-28, Redan 2-3-15, 25, nearly 26 minutes in. Dickinson back in the ruck. He was beaten to it by Govacevic, but it was Matthews. Back to Dundon onto Dickinson. Had his handball partly smothered. Attacking the football was Barker. He was taken high, but that was by his teammate that time. And now the Mamalai like to ball that up. Just forward of centre. Attack inside for Sunbury. Quick thrower. Ruckman will engage. Govacevic got it down. Matthews was in there. Followed it up nicely. Just got the ball on the boot. Goes up the half forward. Ball worked his way forward. McGovern couldn't quite get hands to it, but will accept the handball. Went back. Further still, this time to short. Quick hands to McCabe. Arches the back. Still under pressure inside 50. Turn the handball over. Horbring needed to bend down and pick it up. And getting back just in the nick of time was McCabe. And forced that through for a minor score. And I'm not sure the camera McCabe quite knew where he was going. But Damien Horbring is about 40% fit at the moment.
That's what he was trying. He was trying to throw it up the corridor before, but he just didn't see it.
Kicks in the direction of Horbury, takes a mark just inside the field of play, look to come back in, but just loops a little pass on the left boot. Barker was taken when he didn't have the football play, that's the call. Under pressure, Hay tried to get the handball away. Riordan applies a strong tackle on Coleman that time. The umpire's just holding the whistle at the minute. Eventually he's going to have to move in. No, he doesn't, because Hay did very well. But only as far as Gurkovic, just threw the ball on the boot, goes into the right forward pocket, one bounce and over the boundary line.
David Horbury just tried to be too cute, and he tried to hit up a target. And you could see he was going about it wrong. He didn't have his foot positioned correctly on the football. It was always going to be a disaster. It should just bump it.
Ryle, uncontested, got it down, but didn't take the advantage. It was cheap. On to McCabe again, throws the ball on the left boot. And he's found Kovacevic.
Can't go down the line because Dickinson's standing right in the way.
Sarah Sander Wynn worked his way in front and took a terrific contesting mark. In front of Lamb and Simon Clark. The half forward, Burgess worked his way into the contest. Shark nicely by Meadcraft and goes in the direction of Linton on a good, strong lead.
Beautiful mark by Linton. He timed his jump in effort.
And terrific hands. He's right up against the boundary line. Good side for a right footer. Ah!
Just jumped so that he took the ball at its absolute apex, and the Redan defender had absolutely no chance in that stage.
So the man on the mark, Matthew Hyden, standing 25. Linton cannot step off his mark. He will kick from 30. Meter in from the boundary line, he sends it goalwards and he's kicked it beautifully. So all the momentum with Sunbury to end the opening term. They conceded the opening two goals, but have kicked the last five to take a three-goal lead into the opening break. 5-4-34, they lead Redan 2-4-16. The margin, 18 points. And Sean Kelly, as is tradition on BFL Game of the Round, before we take our quarter time break, in fact, before we take any break, the goal kickers.
The goal kickers for today's game, it's all singles going the way of the Sunbury Football Club. We've got Slide, we've got Minton, we've got Hay, we've got Hill, and we've got Matthew Meadcraft. Forward and one each to Colbert and Dundon. Start finding targets in their forward line.
Yeah, I think Damien Horbury is probably the biggest culprit in that area this afternoon. All right, all in. Puts the ball in the air and it was Karras. Nicely down to Slider, who is knocked off the football. One nicely by Matthews. He can get the opening clearance, bring it inside 50. He was looking for Colbert, but getting back, Coleman took the mark.
Straight away, switching to the opposite side of the ground.
Takes a bounce across the defensive goal square to kick in the direction of Linton. Did the discipline thing, got the defensive spoil in. Hyden was worked off the football by McKay. It's actually James Riss that time who came in. The football over the boundary line.
You're right about that. Sorry, Mick, you're right about that discipline. Xavier Linton, for 95% of that lead, looked like he was going to mark the ball. Once he realised that the defender got in his way, he switched where a lot of people wouldn't, went defensively and caused the ball to go back in 50-50.
Robbing his own right leg was Karras from the Monster, missed with the handball. Linton attacked the football nicely, taking a terrific tackle. Ball emerged eventually, it's going to fall for Karras.
Because it looked like he just stopped and dead-weighted himself into the tackle once he lost the footy.
Yeah, well, maybe on the blind side of it, we got a terrific view of it. And, yeah, got away with one, Paddy Karras, from the ruck contest. He was second in line, but tapped it into the path of Chief. To land one way than the other. Around on the left boot, closing the angles nicely. Tom Linton was able to smother the ball off the land boot.
He fell for peace after Grant Bell handballed him in the back of his head. So, falling as it was quite fortuitous in the end.
Garrett's worked his way forward from the ruck contest. Shepherding open the door for Lonsford first. Hands up there in support. Hands off to Riss. Kick down the line in the direction of Sunik and right on the boundary line. The mark's taken by Sunik on the chest. Just his second game since a serious injury against Daly back in round 12. He'll hug the boundary line again. Clark working his way forward. Terrific contested mark. He'll get around on the left boot. He's got Slide on.
He just appeared out of nowhere then, Ross Slider. No one saw him except Simon Clark, who was displaying some seriously dookish behaviour at this since about the 10-minute mark of the first quarter.
Showing his quality, isn't he?
Slidey will kick this.
Well, he's on a 45-degree angle, man on the mark at 40. Go to 47 now. He started at left. It's going across the face and across the side. Clark, who pushed himself into the goal squares, dragged down a terrific contested mark.
Just
to the left of the goal square. Distance won't be an issue. He'll be kicking from 15 metres out and should just press home the advantage. Well, he's just looped that one goal. I think he's just squeezed it in. Well, he has. So, Simon Clark, it's the opening goal. Oh, if it's the second term for Sunbury, they push out by 24 points. 11-4 goals to margin. Sunbury 6-4-40. Redan 2-4-16 on the BFL Game of the Round, Sean Kelly.
Last six goals to Sunbury now. Things getting desperate for Redan. I reckon they've almost got to make a move if they haven't done so already. They need to get Ryan Wade into the midfield and start to get a bit of that ascendancy going for him. I think they've done that actually because, you know, that's Dean Matthews. I get confused between the perm and the mullet sometimes, so.
Dickinson, Tester got it down. Miles tried to take on a little too much, like not to give the free kick away. Looking a handle over the top is Cheap. Onto the run of Monsell. Monsell go up to half forward, climbing high with Kovacevic. Couldn't bring the mark down, fell to the berm. Got it on to Dickinson. Back to Hyden, back to Matthews. And he'll just swing it wide where he's got Brick. We'll loop the handball over the top and he's got the run of Chester. Should go with a bounce through centre wing. Goes with the second. Ball eventually came back to him. Controls the ball nicely on the boot. Goes in the direction of Riordan, but short getting back on hands to it. For all intents and purposes, that was a Brenton Riordan mark, but short doing very well. Got a fingernail on it, and they've conceded the minus score.
Good test of the hands from Chester then. It showed some pace across the outer wing here. The scoreboard wing at the Eastern Oval.
Riley, ground level. Good contest that time with Sheehan. Fell for Gurkovic, threw the ball on the boot. Colbert set himself to take the mark from the square was Phelps. Perfect. Really control the kick. He's pushed it to the left and another minus score. So Redan with the last two scores, both of those have been minus scores. They're back within 22 points.
No communication for Redan that time. Two players flying against each other in the forward line. Mitch Phelps had the perfect spot for that score. He's just rushed with the kick and as a result slewed it to the left.
So Monsell, kick at the half forward. Ryle set himself and didn't try to take the mark. Coleman, as he got the kick away, but was able to put it and he kicked down the line slide. In front, slipped away by Hyder. Tracked away from Slide, but it's going to be a somebody free kick. No, it's not. It's the umpire's pointing in the wrong direction. I thought it was going to be a Ryle free kick there. Did Ryle kick
to his head? Jarrell Salwood stayed at three, but he was the only one that wanted to pull
that out. That's a low he's got Matthews. The left half forward who drives the ball along to the hot spot, coming across from the side, Goldman.
That's what they need more of up forward. Big, genuine marking forward. Royce Hardstyle floating in from the side that pump that time. It puts him in a good position to say they need this one because they've been taken to the game.
Well, they've conceded the last six goals. Daniel Colville, who kicked the opening goal of the contest, to slightly off centre. Terrific pack mark. And he should be able to put his second on the board for the afternoon. 20 metres out, he just nurses that one home.
Forward, Dan takes him to 3-6, I believe, is it?
3-6-24, this summary. 6-4-4, the margin back to 16 points.
Daniel Colbert's been the only real genuine marking forward they've had in this game so far. Obviously, while presenting high and doing a good job, but Colbert's ability to take a catch in front of the pack, and that was a fantastic mark that he took floating in front of the pack, and they need to do a bit more of that. That was a goal they needed. They can get the next one, all of a sudden they're back into the game.
Supposedly kicking to the advantage end. That's the Peel Street end, ball back in the middle again. Swing early, Dickinson got it down. He's one by Matthews. And again, he'll get down the clearance up the half forward, settling himself back. Just nudged his opponent out nicely, took the mark on the chest, was short, handed off to Coleman, but then turned his kick over. And it was chopped off by, again, the mulligan. Matthews has had a good afternoon thus far. Squared it up where he had spark plug with leaps. It's Barker who goes with the barrel into the corridor. Man in front was short. And across the shoulder that time was Real and gave the free kick away. Somebody took the advantage. Terrific move to get the ball into the first. McKay one way, then the other. He's Corral on the right. In the end, he concedes 20 metres and goes back to McGovern.
Around the ground score, Artie Felt, preliminary final at quarter time. Riddle 5 at 7:37, leading Sunbury Kangaroos 1-2-8. Bombers kick the first two goals of the second quarter. 40 points out, heading for a grand final against Dennis Rosemont's
work. Still on the last line of defence. It's cheap. Run through the defensive goal square. Now we will go to the Southern Railway side. Into a one-out contest. Now, surely a free kick to Sunbury at that time. Not forthcoming. It was Wake. Taken nicely on the half volley by Chester. Got it onto McKenzie. And he just chipped short looking for Eorden. And he was made to earn that mark. He was in front of Coleman, but Coleman quite happy to take him to ground. And Brenton Riordan will line it up. Eccle will play on where he squares it up, and some lax defence work by Sunbury that time. Left the dangerous Mitchell Phelps free. In the corridor, he'll turn around and he'll line it up. Kicking from about 40 metres out, and an opportunity for Redan to get back to back.
Mitch Phelps has shown a little bit today. He hasn't had an opportunity like this, so all his opportunities have been on the run or opportunistic.
So he skips to 40. His left foot. The goal. Splits the middle. And Redan with back-to-back goals. They get the margin back to 10 points. 4-6-30. Sunbury, 6 goals, 4-40. On the BFL game of the round, ticking into 9 minutes. Sean Gallagher.
Just making a quick addition to my sheet. I realised the one person I had not listed on there was Mitch Phelps. There's some really good signs by Redan in the last 5 or so minutes. They're starting to get themselves back into the game. Their work rate's lifted. They're getting some opportunity up forward. And they're getting some clear, uncontested marks, which is the main thing that they need.
So back in the middle. Kovacevic, Ellis Grant nicely down to mid-path, quick hands to the run of Hill, and Hill will keep it low looking for Sunik. True centre-half forward, took the mark in front of Lamb. 50 five out by the time he takes this kick. It's a good long kick going to the teeth of goal. Dan numbers in front. In fact, the ball fell short. It was read much better by one of the youngest players on the ground, Aidan Riley.
Shows no fear, doesn't he?
His reading of the flight of the ball that time was excellent. Just held up in the breeze, and he'll come to the Bowls Club side. He's looking for Lamb. Disciplined work by McCabe. Handball over the top, and just off a range of leaps that time. Finds its way over the boundary line and out of bounds in front of the grandstand. 10 minutes in, 10 points the margin. Novosevic worked his way forward. It was Dickinson who got it down. Chris was taken to ground. Then, while he was legged, according to the umpire, he managed to get the handball out, but he's won himself a free kick at left half back. He's got Horbury on short if he wants him. Takes the mark in front of short.
60 metre lead by Damien Horbury then. He really had to work for that, and he's created some space to kick into.
And he misses. Floats the ball up to half four. Setting himself as complete the mark. Gobert was in there again. Through traffic, Martins Hill. Looked good initially, but then turned the handball over. Well done by Matthews. Gets it on to Phelps. He'll load it up for outside 50. Open goal squaring. Misses it to the near side.
And he'll be cursing because he had Daniel Colbert over the top. He could have Joe the Goose a little handball over, and Colbert would have run into an open goal. Costly mistake by Mitch Phelps.
Equally, that were goals he was kicking. So this time, these two sides met. You back yourself in there. Unfortunately, just couldn't execute. And it was Chambers into the back pocket where he found short. And a looping dangerous pass, diving forward even to his wrist.
Look for somebody to switch here. They've got all their men lined up on the scoreboard side off the ground. Redan have got a lot of real estate covered on that ground, on the scoreboard side.
Matthews was beaten to it by Burgess that time. And he's held in a standing tackle. There was just no movement on the northern side that time, and risk just continued on the southern side. They just seemed themselves to be under a little bit of pressure inside defensive 50. Matthews was taken front on, with a little handball onto Schultz, back and goal this time to Gurkovic, and he goes with the banana off the outer portion of the boot and slammed it into the behind post. Get out of bounds, one in full. In the right forward pocket, or left bank pocket, depending which side you're following, short line. Itself that
say, what's his short long business?
I'm not talking coffees yet.
No.
Slap forward. Very impressive slap by.
That's borderline deliberate.
By Brett Chambers. Mm,
that is borderline deliberate out of bounds when they slap it that
well, I reckon he's slapped that about 30 metres. He's put it over the boundary line on the full. So clear advantage to Sunbury that time. And there was the appeal for deliberate. None forthcoming. It'll be thrown back in now. Ryle was caught behind it, with Sheen in front. But McKenzie should get there first. Managed to free the arms, got it on to Schultz. He was corralled on the right. Couldn't get it back around onto his left. And in the end, the boundary line closed in. And there'll be another boundary thrown. Right on attacking 50. 9 points in favour of Sunbury at the moment. Now, is it Sheen in front? No, in fact, it's going to be a Redan free kick. It's going to go against Sheen. And it'll go the way of Lee Ryle. No, in fact, it must have been a free kick before that because McKenzie gets torn short of it. And McKenzie stands it wide. And there's Matty Harris too. Just taking the mark, just the boundary line. That's Michael Coleman on the mark at 45. So you're needing to kick from just inside 50. Harris with the right footer. Sends it goal. It's just going across the face. Pack converged in the end and fell for Colbert. He tried to snap a goal. It's in the end. Mitch Phelps would go likewise. And a very strange piece of play there because players had actually stopped with that Garris kick. And the ball was still in the field of play. And in the end, it's Phelps who misses to the near side.
Mitch Phelps kicked 1-4 in the afternoon so far. Mark, a lot of them obviously coming from snaps. But to paint the picture of that last piece of play, somebody bringing the ball out of the back line, kick fell short of the goals. Was able to stay inside. A couple of players lead. Daniel Colbert tapped it down, kept it in, had that flying shot, which went across the face of goal. Mitch Phelps was able to get it and snap again as Redan come back inside their forward line.
It's Chambers. Complete the mark. Fell for Dunning over the top here for Phelps. Should be able to run this one home. He does.
second goal for the quarter for Mitch Phelps. Two goals for Redan. Well and truly back into this contest now. It goes to 5-8-38 Redan, 6-4-40 Sunbury. Redan with the last three goals and really threatening once again.
And the margin back to 2 points. But yeah, they've had control of the football over the last probably 10 minutes or so. Sunbury, they got the quick start in their second term. But it has been Redan. They're almost back on terms despite trailing by 18 points at quarter time. Back in the middle, still by now. It's the target. Nice time by Burke. Go long inside 50. Redan forwards there can't quite get into position, and a nice mark taken on the chest by Coleman. Pass over the top, he's got the lead of Hay. Still inside the fence here, 50, it looks like
Sunbury not moving in the forward field.
Now the run has stopped. And the direction of Kovacevic. Actually fell nicely for Gurkovic, who took the mark, will go towards Ryle. Terrific pickup on the half volley by Chambers, and ran it close to, and in the end, over the boundary line.
Really well done by Lee Ryle, because he corralled Chambers towards the boundary line, and Chambers obviously didn't realise he was doing it, but Sunbury flat-footed from that kick, and you always knew Redan were going to repel.
40 around, looping throw-in. Ryle can get a hand on it. Dunham was baited to it. Taken nicely by the by Chamberlain, and then the other. He's forced to stop and pop, got it on to Kostowski. A little slow getting rid of the football, it was dispossessed. Fell nicely for Hay, and Hay will kick down the line to half forward. It is a 3-on-1 situation. It was Lamb across from the side, couldn't complete the mark, but wrenching it out nicely. It was Long Riley. Goes to centre wing, and like Connor said, it's grounded. A terrific contest. Won the football, goes back to Cheap. Wants to go one way, then the other, and then he'll square it up looking for a short. Takes the mark, he'll hand off to Sheehan. On the left boot, you just loop it into the path.
Redan forcing Sunbury bleeding.
Burgess will keep it low. He's got Linton on, although it was Britt who got finger on to it. Riley, the ground level's taken over the shoulder. Maybe just a little sloppy that time by Linton. Gives the free kick up, and Riley.
Redan's really starting to pressure that Sunbury ball carrier, forcing them wide. There's a real lack of movement in the Sunbury forward line at the moment. Redan capitalising it.
Peace, right hand back to Schultz. On to Matthews, back to the runner Schultz, who kept coming. He'll then cut the ball low. He's looking for Chester, I think it was at Bell that time, but just chopped off by Coleman. Coleman will loop a pass over the top. Chambers pushing up, takes the mark.
There's no clear next kick when they come out of half back. The forwards are just, the half forwards are stationary. They're going to have to kick down the line and kick the contest.
And Chambers trying to go short through the hands of Phelps. Was dispossessed, opportunity for Montel onto Chambers, back to Slight, and he turned his handball over, it was taken by Peace, Bell cleverly, back to the run of Hyde, and off a step, he'll just kick the ball on inside 50, but setting himself, he had the height advantage, and it's Sheen who takes the mark, now he'll switch play to Linton, now he's got some run, you're right, go with the bounce here. Clears defensive 50, and he'll keep it low, looking for Sunic, just gone a touch too wide, low fortuitously, and landed just inside the field of play, one bounce over the boundary line, and out of bounds, but probably the quickest ball movement that Sunbury have had for a while, just not able to execute. Both of them contested, Harris decisively got a bounce. Riley seemed to be pushed fair and square in the back against Mick. That's the way the umpire seen it. Riley squared up, but he's got Hyde. Found it out wide, he's got Schultz with a little bit of run. Good pressure applied by Clark, but he's still got the kick away. Looking for Chester. Was he taken when he didn't have the football? May have been impeded in the run or a push in the back. Any one of those three. And Chester.
Just on the edge of his range, I reckon he's going
to
kick
this
from about 53.
Coleman just inside the 50-metre arc. Chester. Approach 50 now. It's from 52. There's penetration to that, but the accuracy is not there. He just pushes it to the right. Another minus score. Sunbury after kicking the opening goal of this second term. Actually conceded the next 8 scoring shots. Margin just a point. So McCabe the back pocket, he'll kick down the line. He's got a player on in short who takes the mark, approach centre wing. Again, kicks down the line up to half forward, looking for Burgess. Now she's punted out nicely, did all the hard work, couldn't complete the mark. Spilling onto it is Sunik, needs to get back around on the left boot. Went through the hands of Grid, opportunity here for Medcraft. We'll leave it for Sunik, got back around on the left boot. Just runs it towards the goals, opportunity for Linton there, but sensing the danger, it was Waite. The defensive spoil on it, put it through for a minus score. Redan will come out quickly, looking for Lamb, complete the mark, he tried to back himself back into the pack. He was taken the lead tackle, but he was also taken over the boundary line. There'll be another boundary throw-in, margin back to 2 points. Ruckman will contest, it was Kovacevic got it down, but Colbert won it, and he can clear Redan momentarily. In fact, he just landed it inside the field of play.
Reasonably
just defensive
smart,
side.
He didn't have anything really to keep to, so try and thump it as far forward as you can and disguise the fact that he's looking at the boundary line. Yep. He did well, gives Redan 40 metres to play with, the ball's now 2 kicks from Sunbury's goal.
Defensive side, southern wing. Karras got it down, just won nicely by Montel. Himself out of traffic expertly, goes on the half forward. It was dropped by Matthews, but had time to recover. Hamill missed the target, opens the door this time for Burgess. Went with the don't argue. His handball was partly smothered, ricocheted off the hands of Ben Schultz that time, and again over the boundary line. Drew centre wing for something on the railway side. 5-9, placing 6-5. Boundary throwing. Down to Matthews, who's taken high, who's taken front off.
The man on the mark that made the tackle questioning the umpire's decision, which I probably thought was correct that he questioned it, because I didn't think that he slipped over. Having said that, the ball was on the other side of the ground to where we were, but the price to pay for questioning the umpire's decision was just accepted. Move on.
So Matthews, too far out to score, a hands off to the runner Bell. He'll load it up from outside 50, and he's pushed it again to the right. Oh, and they converted all of their opportunities in the second turn, Redan.
15 scores
on the top of the scores are over. On the Bowls Club side, it was Styles up to Sunik, who took the mark, and then he was off, forced to play on, with the handball over the top. Clark needs a good bounce. Unfortunately, it's set up long enough to let Everett come in to that particular contest and force the ball over the boundary line and out of bounds.
I don't think he had consciously played on then. I think he just got the stumbles when he hit the ground after the mark. As you can see, he fell over pretty well straight away. Because he stumbled in a forward trajectory, though, umpire called play on.
So a flat throw in. It was Peace got it down. It was won by Medcraft. His handball missed the target. Bell needed to keep his footing, although he was able to retrieve the football. Got it onto Gergovic. Now he's got the run of Barker. Goes with a bounce through the middle. Now he'll go up to right half forward and out in front. Chester takes the mark. Too far out to score. 2.5 out from goal. He'll go in the direction of Horbury. Chambers was pushed in the back. He was impeded as he went for that mark against Damien Horbury. Chambers will take the free kick. He's got Hill on the 2.5 back. No one within about 10 metres of him. He'll swing the ball wide where he's got Parker. Parker's got the run of flanks, stops and props, and then he'll kick down the line looking for Sunik. Out in front, but terrific desperation shown by Lamb. Diving forward, got the defensive spoil on it. Stops Sunik from taking the mark and forced the ball over the boundary line and out of bounds, 23.
Nick Hughes' last two leads have been onto that and that been to the boundary side. He's probably more looking at the more up the ground than chops Lamb's forcing him to lead out to the boundary. So good defensive work from there.
We're down at half forward. It was Harris back to Ryle this time, and he'll go in the direction of Fowler. Drop the one he should have taken, had time to recover, and then off the way out of part of the boot. Just slew it in the direction of Scotty Bowl. Took the mark.
Gotta go, Chief!
Harris worked his way forward, tried to spike it down. It was won by Parker onto Scott Bowl, and his kick smothered in the middle of the ground. McCabe got an ordinary bounce. It was won by a piece on Hyden. Hyden will found it wide, where he's got Karras. He'll look to come back inboard. Again, a floating ball, but all the numbers there for Redan. And it's Phelps who takes the mark on the chest to true centre half forward.
Sticky for the lead. Phelps is seventh shot at goal.
Now he'll load it up. 55 out. It's just going to fall short. Goes to the teeth of goal. Chambers got back, got hands to it. Won by Coleman. Back in board to the run of Short. And Short's got a player on in Linton, defensive side of centre wing on the Southern Railway side of the ground. Pass over the top, looking for Clark down in front of Britt. Takes the mark. 2.5 kicks from goal. Go half forward. Sunic trying to send himself, couldn't complete the mark. Schultz was there, got it on to Britt. Brittle handball back in board, looking for Lamb, couldn't take it down low. Opportunity for Parker, then he turned his handball over to Matthews. Matthews just loops a little pass in the direction of LeVar. McKenzie was front and square that time, and he was taken, but he didn't have the footy. Former Mildura boy takes the
Diggins
in the middle of the ground. Got the run of Phelps. Off a step goes looking for Riordan. And Silver short. Now falls from McKay. Need to get the kick away. He goes up the half forward. Pop behind was slight. It was cheap. Couldn't complete the mark. It fell for slight nicely. And then he's got Linton, who's done some running in the last minute or so. Finds himself at right half forward on the Northern or Bowls Club side of the ground. He takes the mark on the chest. Not without a chance here, Xavier Linton. He'll take his very best kick.
Just approaching 26 minutes in the quarter as well.
From outside the boundary. Comes inside 50 now. Never looked good off the boot. It's just starting to draw back a little bit, having started it right. But he's missed it. To the right-hand side, minus score. Here's though, Sunbury settled in the last 5 minutes or so. Just stem the flow a little bit. Martin back out to 2 points. More on a little scale. Gunnan set himself nicely after a long kick out from fullback. He's got the runner Colbert. He's closed down, but still got the kick away, but he's turned it over. Shane takes the mark.
The difference Redan took by going straight down the middle out of their kick out rather than going wide like they had earlier in the quarter. So different. Jesse Gunnan able to take the one out mark and they got the ball to half forward.
So it's Stiles to Karras. Back to Stiles, conceded 10 metres with the handball and then a terrific pass into a strong lead by Linton. Posing himself this afternoon. Linton bring it inside 50 looking for Clark. 1-2. Takes the mark on the second effort. Right at left half forward. He looked to float the ball into the corridor, looking for slight. Was he taken high? Not according to the umpire. Front and square was Medgar. Ah! So I wonder whether somebody will look back on that opportunity there. Clean hands by Ross Slide. Also clean hands before that by Matthew Medgar. Made very well. They've seen Sunbury with a goal right on the half-time siren. As it was, they've missed out, and they've been well and truly outscored in the second term. They led by 18 points at the opening break, but after conceding 3-6 to just 1-2, the Eastern Lions lead by just 2 points.